Good evening. Welcome to St. Michael. We offer a special welcome to all visitors who are with us this evening and to those viewing the live stream. Printed worship aids are available in the entrances. April 21st is the World Day of Prayer for Vocations. We will be praying the Archdiocesan Prayer for Vocations at the end of our intercessions this weekend. Prayer cards will also be available in the Northex after Mass and also in the chapel for those who wish to take a copy home. Our next round of parish small groups are starting now. The groups are focused on a wide variety of topics and interests. Please visit the parish website to find out more about these new small groups and how to join. There is even a group that meets between the 8:30 and 10:30 Sunday Masses to discuss Father Tom's homework and homilies. Please join us. Come and see. Next Saturday is April Fest. We are in need of wine donations for the wine wall, baked goods for the bake sale, and craft or homemade items for the boutique. Committee members will be in the back of the church after Mass to help sign up volunteers, provide more information, and answer any questions.
Let us rise and sing number 797 in the Gather Hymnal, Baptized in Water. Number 797 in the Gather Hymnal.
By the blood. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of the risen Christ be with you.
Amen.
My friends, I hope you could feel the joy when you walked in this afternoon. Earlier today, we had celebrated First Holy Communion for 41 of our little children. This afternoon, Caleb and Sophia are going to make their First Holy Communion at this Mass, so we lift them up in prayer. And it all begins in that beautiful sacrament of baptism. So we start our Easter Mass, once again asking God's blessing on our Easter waters, our baptismal waters. As we are sprinkled with them, may we be reminded of the promises we made in baptism. Lord our God, in your mercy, be present to your people's prayers, and for us recall the wondrous work of our creation and still greater work of our redemption. Graciously bless this water. For you created waters to make the fields fruitful and to refresh and cleanse our bodies. You also made water the instrument of your mercy. For through water you freed your people from slavery and quenched their thirst in the desert. Through water which Christ made holy in the Jordan, you have renewed our corrupted nature in the bath of regeneration. Therefore, may this water be for us a memorial of the baptism we have received, and grant that we may share in the gladness of our brothers and sisters who at Easter have received their baptism. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Glory, glory to God in the highest. Glory, glory to God in the highest. And on earth, peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you.
Prayer, we continue to lift up in prayer Joe Reardon, whose funeral services were here on Friday. Beautiful story from his funeral. So he has, I can't even get the count right, I'm sure, how many children, grandchildren, great-grandchildren. He and his wife have been married for almost 72 years. But during the funeral, the third pew back was almost all great-grandchildren, none of them old enough to receive their first communion. And they were rowdy the whole funeral. But, we got to the Lord's Prayer, and about half a beat behind, the whole row. Our Father, who art... It was beautiful. Our great-great-grandpa had to be so happy. There's nothing more important to teach our little ones. And then I've been reading those Why I Want to Be Confirmed letters. And a young man, mind you, he talked about how some of the usual things I often hear, and then he said, I hope to be back, be a table leader for confirmation next year. I want to get involved in faith formation, teaching our children. And then he said, and if I have children someday, I want to be able to talk to them about the faith. Now, how many 16-year-old boys are even thinking about children, much less the rest? I think that's a very good sign for our future. Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, lead us to share in the joys of heaven so that a humble flock may reach where the brave shepherd has gone before, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter, filled with the Holy Spirit, said, "Leaders of the people and elders, if we are being examined today about a good deed done to a cripple, namely, by what means he was saved, then all of you and all the people of Israel shall know that it was in the name of Jesus Christ the Nazarene, whom you crucified, whom God raised from the dead. In his name, this man stands before you healed. He is the stone rejected by you, the builders, which has become the cornerstone. There is no salvation through anyone else, nor is there any name under heaven given to the human race by which we are to be saved." The word of the Lord.
Stone rejected by the builders has become the cornerstone. The stone rejected by the builders has become the cornerstone. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endures forever. It is better to take refuge in the Lord than to trust in man. It is better to take refuge in the Lord than to trust in princes. The stone rejected by the builders has become the cornerstone. I will give thanks to you, for you have answered me and have been my Savior. stone which the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. By the Lord has this been done. It is wonderful in our eyes. The stone rejected by the builders has become the cornerstone. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. We bless you from the house of the Lord. I will give thanks to you, for you have answered me and have been my Savior. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his kindness endures forever. The stone rejected by the builders has become the cornerstone, has become the cornerstone.
A reading from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, see what love the Father has bestowed on us, that we may be called the children of God. Yet so we are. The reason the world does not know us is that it did not know him. Beloved, we are God's children now. What we shall be has not yet been revealed. We do not know that when it is revealed, we shall be like him, for we shall see he is as he is. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said, I am the good shepherd. A good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. A hired man who is not a shepherd and whose sheep are not his own sees a wolf coming and leaves the sheep and runs away, and the wolf catches and scatters them. This is because he works for pay and has no concern for the sheep. I am the good shepherd, and I know mine, and mine know me, just as the Father knows me, and I know the Father, and I will lay down my life for the sheep. I have other sheep that do not belong to this fold. These also I must lead, and they will hear my voice, and there will be one flock, one shepherd. This is why the Father loves me, because I lay down my life in order to take it up again. No one takes it from me, but I lay it down on my own. I have the power to lay it down and the power to take it up again. This command I have received from my Father. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. There was a little girl in the Catholic school, and her class was preparing for the year-end program, and they were memorizing Psalm 23. I am, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. And they were memorizing the whole passage, and it was very difficult for this little girl. Even with lots of practice, she never got through it completely. But on the day of the program, she volunteered to recite Psalm 23. She stood up and started confidently, "The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want." A long pause, and the other kids were starting to snicker. And then she smiled and said, "And that's all I need to know." I think that's a very good prayer. The Lord is my shepherd, and that's all I need to know. Or if you'd like to take a full look at Psalm 23, I encourage you to do that. A lot of good shepherding images there of how the Lord is in our life. During these weeks of Easter, we hear about who Jesus is. We come to know that he is the Christ, he is the suffering servant, he is the Son of God, and now the Good Shepherd. And we come to know who we are. First, like the disciples, a little bit confused, questioning. Then they come to know that they are sent. The Spirit is with them. Today we learn that we are children of God. Of God. And as we reflect on this, it becomes really the foundation, the cornerstone of our faith, that God, the Lord, Christ is our shepherd, and we are the children of God. I think that's what the little girl came to know. She knew Jesus in that way and knew who she was. We hear that in the first letter of John. "See what love the Father has bestowed on us that we may be called children of God. Yet that is what we are. Beloved, we are God's children now." God's children. Have you ever reflected on that? Yes, I know I'm a child of my parents, but I'm also a child of God. In a sense, I have some divine DNA in me. We have value. We have dignity because of that. Children of God, King, Lord of the universe, part of God's kingdom. Guys, you are princes in the kingdom of God. Gals, you are princesses in the kingdom of God. We have worth, we have dignity. We have been created in the image and the likeness of God. How many times do people say, "Wow, you look just like your brother. Wow, just like your mom. I can see your mom in you." Created in the image and likeness of God. Or how many times as you get older do you say, "Where did that come from? That was just like my mother. Or that was just like my father." We're coming into that image and likeness of our parents. So let us live into that image and likeness of God our Father. In baptism, we are joined to Christ as another Christ, brothers and sisters with Christ. As priest, prophet, and king, we have that royalty with us. And just as the kings and priests and prophets were anointed, we too are anointed at baptism with the oil that's rubbed into the crown of our head. We are royalty in the kingdom of God. Does that change your understanding of who you are? Of who others are? We're not just dealing with one another, even our enemies or the black sheep of our family or our brother, our sister, our parent, our kids, our boss, whoever it might be. We're dealing with others who are our brothers and sisters in the kingdom, in the family of God. So, live like it. Act like it. Represent the family well. And take up the family business. Shepherding. We are shepherded by God, by Christ. And we take that and go into our roles as shepherds of others. Shepherds, we learn from God and his voice in and through creation and the events of beauty and goodness. We learn through people in our lives, especially family and friends who care for us, guide us, comfort us, bring us into the mercy of God. We learn through the liturgy and the word, in sacrament, in song, in prayer. We come to know we are children of God. We come to know the love of God in our life. And we know it, God's voice to ourselves, with inspiration, guidance, direction, purpose, dreams, all from the Holy Spirit that help us know who we are. And then, because we are part of the family of God, we take what we receive, we take what we are, who we are, outward. And thus all the ministries of the church, some inside our community here, some out into the wider community. We take out God's love. God bestowed through love that we are children of God. We take that out with us and bring that to others. Whether we are clergy, whether we are laity, whether we are religious or consecrated, we all have that mission from our baptism, the waters of baptism, the oil of baptism, to share that love and that knowledge, simple knowledge. We are loved by God, and God has bestowed on us that love in the form of we are family with God, with Christ. And I think that's what the little girl knew, that the Lord is my shepherd. And there's nothing else I need to know. That becomes the cornerstone and the foundation of our faith. And all else is kind of dependent on that. But we have a sure cornerstone. So let us also acknowledge that the Lord is my shepherd, and there is nothing else I shall want.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us men and for our salvation. He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. And on this Good Shepherd Sunday, I invite you to take out your black books. We're going to have a special prayer. We'll pray at the end of our petitions. So have your books open to the Vocations Prayer at number 94 in the black books. Have that ready to go. Now let's place our needs this day before our loving God.
On this World Day of Prayer for Vocations, we pray that the Holy Spirit will create a culture of vocations in our diocese, and that young people in our own parish will respond to the Lord's invitation to become priests, brothers, and sisters. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That parents will be open to priestly and religious vocations within their families, and that they will encourage their children to seriously consider every vocation. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For children of our parish who celebrated First Holy Communion this morning, and for Caleb and Sophia Baumgartner, who will be celebrating First Holy Communion at this Mass, that they will experience God's love for them and God's care and protection each day. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For leaders of nations, that God will give them a heart like the Good Shepherd, compassion towards those who are suffering, and wisdom to develop policies that advance the common good. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an end to violence, that the Good Shepherd will protect all of God's children from acts of violence. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all living in loneliness at home, in nursing facilities, or in retirement residencies, for the recovery of those seriously ill in hospitals or intensive care units, and for safety and health of all caregivers, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the faithful departed, and for Gilbert Bud Anderson, for whom this Mass is offered, may they all live forever with Christ in the glory of the resurrection. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the intentions that we hold in the quiet of our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Now let's pray our prayer for vocations. O God, we earnestly ask you to bless this archdiocese with many priests, brothers, and sisters who will love you with their whole strength and gladly spend their lives to serve your church and make you known and loved. Bless our families, bless our children, choose from our homes those needed for your work. Mary, Queen of the Clergy, pray for us, pray for our priests, religious, and deacons, obtain for us many more. Amen. Please be seated. You are invited, if you wish, on the way out. There are little vocations prayer cards that you can take home and use to pray with your family. What a beautiful, just throughout this week, if not ongoing, when you say your prayer, say over dinner every night, we say grace as a family to pray for more vocations. We've been so blessed. We had a ordination of the priest with Father Ryan. Sister Felicity made her final vows this last summer. We have two in seminary right now that we are praying for, Noah and Ashton, but I know there are many more young people's hearts that are being touched. And as you pray that way, I really hope you also pray for our Good Shepherd, our Holy Father in Rome, Pope Francis, for Archbishop Hebda, for all who lead God's people, that they will have that heart of a Good Shepherd. Thank you.
Let us sing number 624 in the Gather Hymnal, Shepherd of My Heart, number 624.
Shepherd is the Lord, for nothing shall I want. Green are the pastures where I'm led to repose. Near waters still and deep, God will refresh my soul.
Pray, my friends, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, our loving Father. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that we may always find delight in these paschal mysteries, so that the renewal constantly at work within us may be the cause of our unending joy, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, Lord, but in this time above all to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. He never ceases to offer himself for us, but defends us and ever pleads our cause before you. He is the sacrificial victim who dies no more, the Lamb once slain who lives forever. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. The time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Bernard our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen, 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 amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to sing, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace, Lord Jesus, be with you always.
Spirit. Let us offer to one another a sign of Christ's peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are we who are called to the supper of the Lord. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Our communion song is New Creation. You'll find it in the worship aid.
Look upon your flock, kind shepherd, and be pleased to settle in eternal pastures the sheep you have redeemed by the precious blood of your Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. It is a wonderfully busy time. Great things happening. Next Saturday is April Fest. The weather is going to be perfect because I put Deacon Terry in charge. So if there are showers, you know who to talk to, of course. But so far, it looks pretty good. We still need some help. In fact, in addition to help on Saturday, I think we're still looking for some extra help on Sunday morning for the pancake breakfast. So folks back there would love to tell you about ways you can help, donations you can still make. I'm so grateful. You know, I really pushed last week, and by about Wednesday, I think we were 75, 80% full, but still have a little ways to go. We can all make it a success. So I just love, that. I think back to that first year I was here, sitting in my office early on Saturday morning, watching all the fans of little kids coming down there. Just a great way to have a fun community event. Continue to pray, as I said, for vocations. There are wonderful little cards that you can pick up on your way out with our Archdiocesan Vocations Prayer. And Michelle Gillette Lackel right back there would be more than happy to tell you about the work that Sarah is doing to help support vocations or other ways that you can pray for more people to open their heart to God's call in that way. Parish small groups have started now or are just starting, so it's not too late to get in on the action. I think there are groups meeting pretty much every day of the week, different ages, so on and so forth. So check that out if you haven't already. As I said the first time around, if you can't go every single week, that's fine. They'll take you whenever you can make it there. All kinds of different topics to do that. Finally, if you need to get away from Fry Wake for a little bit, I got some great options for you. First of all, we're right up on the deadline for signing up to go to Chimbote in July. It's not past the deadline, but if you're going to get airline tickets and all the other things, you want to do that soon. I think we have 14 people signed up to go down to build homes in July, and your generosity just overwhelms me. The money has come in. We're already over $125,000 this year, and that's going to go a long way in keeping people, building houses, keeping people fed, and so on. But if you're interested in that, we'd love to tell you more about that. I'll tell you all about that. We have a special opportunity a little closer to home. The Grotto of the Redemption in Iowa is a beautiful place, a little parish kind of out in the middle of a cornfield, or out, you know, in the, I always call Iowa out in the middle of nowhere, anyhow, no offense to people from Iowa, but I visited there over 30 years ago, and they've done some great work since then. So check out, there are flyers on the tables. We're going to do a little day trip, so we'll leave in the morning, we'll be back by like 7, 8 o'clock at night, have a chance to tour and have mass, and pray there. So that will be coming up on June 27, something like that. It's on the flyer back there. I think it's a Wednesday. So check that out. Finally, we still have some openings for our pilgrimage to Ireland in the fall. That's a great opportunity. So you can check that out. We need to hear from you fairly soon. And Susie's going, so that's a good enough reason to go right there. She'll tell you all about it. We also want to make sure, of course, that we thank God for all of our first communicants, and particularly congratulate Caleb and Sophia, who made their first Holy Communion this evening. God bless you. Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go in peace. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia.
Let us sing Alleluia, Love is Alive. You'll find it on the back page of the worship aid.
God who was of night, tell the world, He is alive. Hear the good news of this glorious day, every heart singing as heaven proclaims, He is Lord, He is Lord. Thank you.